I know one of the things that you were impressed with, even though he didn't factor in the scoring, was the way that Tyler Bertuzzi was sort of battling his way through the Rangers with the puck tonight, Mick.
You have to watch this guy day in and day out, and puck battles, stick battles, feet battles, no matter what it is or what part of the body that Tyler Bertuzzi gets involved with these plays, he seems to come up with a loose puck. And I just grabbed, you know, two or three examples today. Knocked down, goes to the boards, gets position. Who gets the puck? Bertuzzi. Who makes the play? Bertuzzi. Watch this one. Back behind him, loses it. Right foot, makes the play. Defenseman, go to the net. He's unbelievable. He just keeps finding ways. Again, position on the boards. Loose puck, makes the play. Scoring chance. Time after time. Look at it, another one. Hits his leg, makes the play. Follow the play up. This could go on and on and on. It's unbelievable how this guy has a magnet on his stick. It's like glue, Larry. But he plays the game that way, and obviously very effectively with the numbers he's put up. Look at that great scoring chance there. Good save by Shesterkin. But game after game, day after day, this guy does the same thing. It's no coincidence. He's unbelievable in retrieving pucks like that. Incredible.
Well, you touched on his offensive strength of the game. Playing against Tyler Bertuzzi would have drove me crazy.
No kidding.
Because he's never out of the play. You could never get away from him. He always gets his stick in there. He's a nightmare to play against.
That's why they call him a junkyard dog.
How many times have we seen him create turnovers?
He's got those eyes that don't have backs. They have no backs in them. And he doesn't know where the wall is. It's like, I'm going to do whatever I got to do to get the job done. That's the kind of guy, that's why they call him a junkyard dog. He's like that in junior, and he's like that his whole career in the NHL. That's why he's such a valued guy wherever he's playing.
All right, and I want just one more comment about his skating. He's not the guy, he doesn't look like he's fleet of foot. It's not, but he gets there. He's always there on time. If there's a battle for the puck, his stick is right there. He's never a case where somebody gets there before he does, but you would never consider him such a great skater.
No, you wouldn't, and the reason he does get so effective is because of what's between his ears. When you don't skate, like Larkin skates, it's up here. He just knows how to get at the right place at the right time, and he's so effective at that. So good for him.
All right, you mentioned Larkin. It was sort of reminded us of Joe Louis Arena and the very friendly backboards there that led to the Larkin goal. It's our Xfinity high-speed highlight that ended up putting the Wings up by 2-1 at that point. And obviously Larkin is doing lots of things right offensively.
Well, there's a couple things here. When Danny DeKeyser sees a guy in front of him, I'm not 100% sure that he just said, I'm going to bank it off the boards to Larkin. I think he did, but and we'll talk to Danny later in the week when they get back. They have a few days off. But the bottom line is, he's got a guy in front of him right there, and you know Larry is a defenseman. If you don't get that puck through that guy that's defending in front of you, you're going to hear it when you get back to the bench. You got to get it around him, and when can't do it on the net, go to the side of the net, whatever it takes. Whether it was that or just a design play, you could see Larkin off to the right, and Dylan went down on one knee, and bang, right in the top corner. Larkin has been absolutely remarkable this year. He's on a mission. And boy, is it paying dividends.
Well, yeah, I've heard you use the expression, make yourself available. And Larkin was available in that area. He moves himself. He positioned himself where he couldn't be covered, but he moved himself into a position where he's dangerous. And he did get that bounce off the boards to him. But still, I mean, look where he got the puck. And he was wide open. I mean, he was inside the dot area.
Yep.
Great job, Mick. I mean, how difficult, you beat a goal scorer, how he got himself turned towards the net. I mean, it's not easy. He's moving down towards the net, and he's got to get himself turned. I mean, I thought that was an impressive point on that goal. It's just how Larkin got himself in a position where he could get the puck on the net.
I liken being able to score goals in a situation like that, like a basketball player who takes a pass from the sidelines. The basket's behind him, John, and he just wheels and fires and being able to hit nothing but net, nothing but net.
Yeah.
And a hockey player, the same thing. You got to be ready and get out of the traffic and hope that the puck comes to you. And when it does, you're ready to get go. If he doesn't snap it right away, Shesterkin gets over there full time and probably catches it. But he got it off right away. Boom, off the glove, into the top of the net. And he's been really good at that. And he's practicing that every day he gets a chance to.
We'll leave you with this. We love to surprise you with some history that that you may not know about.
Okay.
Any idea how many games you played at Madison Square
Garden?
Oh,
no, I have
not. You played, two at the old garden.
Well, hey, I remember the old garden had chicken wire behind the net.
Oh,
that was a different address before this new fantangled, right? Whatever they call it. The MSG. Go ahead.
And then 23 at the new place.
Wow.
Eight goals in 23 games for you.
In the garden?
At the garden.
No
yeah.
way. Really?
Yeah.
It's not a bad average.
No, that's pretty good.
Really?
I thought you'd enjoy. You'll be smiling. As you're driving through the snow tonight, you'll be smiling thinking about scoring eight goals at the garden.
I gotta check that. I don't know how you guys get those
games.
Get those numbers, but I remember the old garden. I was with Montreal at the time. I was a 19-year-old kid. And then the new one, of course. But I can remember, Larry, I wanted to take you there before we go. After the warm-up in Madison Square Garden, you know, you're always skating around behind the net. I mean, there's the old building.
Oh,
my God, look at that. Look at that. Oh, my God. That's crazy. That's the old days.
Yeah.
Oh, my. I love those old films. There's Gordy, number 9, taking a shot. Harry Howell on the right. What a great defenseman he was for the Rangers. But that ice was so rutted up after the warm-up alone that you couldn't even handle a puck back there. Do you remember that as a defenseman?
Oh, I know. I mean, the Madison Square Gardens, to me, when I play in it, and from what we saw tonight, I don't think it's changed. I mean, they spent $1 billion on renovation. They obviously didn't spend anything on the ice. But that was all, to me, that was always the worst ice in the National Hockey League. And I remember, like, we talked about a bit of it before this game. I remember coming to Madison Square Gardens. I played the first playoff game with Los Angeles. We got there, and the circus was in town, and the dirt was still on the floor. And this was like 2 hours before the game.
Oh, yeah.
So you could just imagine what the ice was like for that one.
So now you get off the bus at the street level, and you walked around that tunnel all the way to the back of the building.
The ramp.
You go up to the fifth floor. And that's where the ice surface was. You walked by the elephants where they had them caged. They were right next to the dressing room. And usually there was stuff on the floor there, too.
Yeah.
And it wasn't dirt. And, oh, my God, that place stunk. It was a circus smell. How can you argue with that? Candy floss and elephant dung. It ain't bad. We're still here today to laugh about it. And what a great memory. Oh, my God.
Yeah, I think we've reached a new plateau here on Red Wings Live Postgame.
Elephant dung.
Hey, enjoy the weekend off. We'll see you on next Wednesday. We're going to be at Ozzy's place, which should be great fun.
Can't wait.
All right.
Colorado coming to town. And by the way, guys, I believe, not final, 4-1 Long Island over the Bruins. Red Wings 2 points tonight, 5 back of the Bruins.
Wow, okay.
Albeit 3 games in hand,
all
have
right.
the Boston Bruins.
Yeah, all right.
So good stuff.
Drive safe. Thank you.
See you, gang.
The great Mickey Redmond joining us.